we started to travel around. And at the beginning, Gary and I were very much into the counterculture scene in Amsterdam, and the Isle of Wight Rock Festival, London. But something was happening to me. I remember at the Isle of Wight, it was the largest rock festival of our generation, much bigger than Woodstock, as far as the amount of people, bands that were playing there. And I remember we were pretty close to the stage, and Jimi Hendrix was performing. That music coming out of those amplifiers was so loud. It seemed to be shaking the mountains, stirring the sea, and scattering the clouds. There was a voice in my heart, a silent voice, that seemed louder than all the music, that was calling me away from it. What I felt I fit in so nicely, the counterculture, what I gave up my parents' lifestyle and accepted all kinds of mistreatment. Because in those days, if you had long hair, it was not a style. It was a radical political statement against the government and the establishment. And people didn't like that. And I was thinking that through this counterculture, we're going to bring peace into the world through love and through music. But I started to see the same things that we were revolting against in the establishment were very much present within the counterculture, just in a different dress, with a different hairstyle, and with different words. Selfishness, egotism, prejudices. I didn't know where I fit in. I loved it, but something was calling me away from it all. Just about a week or so later, Gary and I were in Surbiton, the suburb of London. Can you tell them, Gary?
When we heard Jimi Hendrix had died.
Sit here.
Oh, gosh. All of a sudden, we heard this terrible news that Jimi Hendrix had died of a drug overdose. He had been one of our generation's idols. I mean, he stood for everything that, you know, that we wanted to stand for, you know, and he was a great musician, a great guitar player, and he died of a drug overdose. And it was then that we began wondering, maybe the counterculture, as he's calling it, is maybe something's wrong there too, you know, maybe drugs and free love and partying and music and rock music and all that isn't the answer.